When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
The buddy comedy film, Anger Management. This one is very funny, and I consider this one of the better movies Adam Sandler has been. Yeah, I would consider this one an underrated gem. So the story of this one is that a businessman named Dave Busnett, he is sentenced to anger management therapy after an incident on an airplane. And the ironic thing is, it wasn't really even his fault.
Okay, just calm down.
I am calm. I just want my headset.
Sir, our country is going through a very difficult time right now, and if you're not going to cooperate...
Oh, no, I'm going to cooperate. My plan is to get the headset from you, watch the movie, and laugh in a very cooperative way.
Is there a problem here, sir?
I don't think so.
Can you come to the back of the plane with me so we can have a talk?
A talk about what? There's not a problem. The flight attendant keeps ignoring me when I ask...
Calm down.
I am calm. What is it with you people?
You people?
Oh, now wait a minute. I don't mean you people, I mean you people.
Sir, I will not tolerate any racist behavior on the plane. This is a very difficult time for our country.
I know that. I'm not a racist. I just want to watch the movie.
I'm only going to say this one more time, sir. Calm down.
I'm calm!
And so after that incident, he gets a therapist with unconventional methods. And from there, it's a movie that is not only very enjoyable, it's entertaining, it's hilarious. And the thing is, there's some good acting in this movie. Original story is fast-paced. And this movie's not even boring, not even close to it. At the end of the day, while this is not a heartfelt movie, it teaches an important lesson about keeping calm under pressure. Now, the chemistry between Jack Nicholson and Adam Sandler is amazing. Like, Adam Sandler, he doesn't try to overdo Jack Nicholson here. He underplays it. It actually works pretty well for both of them. Now, Adam Sandler himself, well, let's just say most of his later movies weren't so great. But here, he does a good job. And, you know, there are so many hysterical scenes, especially when John C. Reilly shows up. He has a small cameo as a monk. And I think that scene there is just definitely one of the highlights of this film. Now, Marissa Tomei, she did a alright job. She's not in the film much. She's playing the girlfriend of Dave Busnett. But you know, the mere fact, when I first saw this film so long ago, I was like, you know, this is great. I wish these two actors did more movies together because, you know, it's the main clutch of this film. And I will say there are some negative reviews out there on this one. And I can see why. The plot is not that great. The ending is corny. But overall, I like how this film doesn't take itself too seriously. And just the brilliant acting between Jack Nicholson and Adam Sandler. This is one of the best comedy films I've seen. No. Will it leave you with a whole lot of laughing? Of course it is. And if you somehow haven't seen this one, then certainly check this one out because it is well worth the time. I'm giving this film a 7 out of 10. Who would have thought that Jack Nicholson would have just been downright hysterical in this? But then again, he did play the Joker in 1989's Batman, so there's that. Nonetheless, a better plot and more attention to other characters within this one would have been much appreciated. But overall, I think this film is pretty decent for what it is. And it's a movie you could just sit down and have an entertaining time with. And that is my review of the film, Anger Management. Alright, leave your comments down below in the section. And let me know what you think about this movie. Okay, this is Slim Guy 172 saying, peace out.